Right now, though, Braydon, you've been checking out the new 50 Shades Darker movie. I don't know whether that would be your cup of tea. Is it your cup of tea?
You know what? It's not my cup of tea, and that totally just comes down to my personal preference. I will say on national television, I have read all the books, though.
Right.
And me too. And
I actually think that might have ruined it for me because your imagination can work way better than any sort of film. And I'm one of those weird people that I had it cast before the first film came out, and I was convinced it was Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone.
Right.
So when I see these two, I'm like, nah, it's not them. That's not what I'm imagining. But this is obviously the continuing saga of Christian and Anastasia. This is where she starts to get her own sort of little bit of sass back. And as you can see here, she started to sort of play his games.
$10,000.
I didn't know you had a place
in
Aspen.
I'm a lot of places.
Some ski lovers in the room tonight.
$19,000.
Thank you, sir. A week of luxury in America's finest ski resort.
$24,000.
New blood. $24,000. I am bid. Do I hear $25,000?
The money was for you.
And now it'll go to someone who needs it.
Looks as if the young
lady. I don't know whether to worship at your feet or spank you.
Look, what I would say is if you're one of those people that needs to complete the set, like me with books, I have seen the first film, so, you know, second film, then do see it, you're not going to regret seeing it, but it's not one of the great blockbusters of all time. It's not going to be one of those films that
people
talk about.
Well, the first one wasn't, let's be honest.
No, and I would say, you know, it's pretty much on par with that, and I feel very unkind saying that. I showed you that clip because I couldn't really show you anything else.
Yeah. No, but I love your honesty, though, babe.
I went with a friend to the first one, and I forgot this friend has the most raucous laugh, and she just went the whole way through it.
Laughing through the film.
Yeah.
At the absolute other end of the spectrum, a lot of talk about this, and deservedly so, Fences, and I know that you've been along to see this. What were your thoughts?
It felt very worthy. It's based on a play, and you can tell. Denzel's amazing. They're incredible performances. It's not a happy movie.
No, it's not. So Denzel Washington, Viola Davis as well. This has had 93 award nominations, 23 wins already. In the first couple of screenings they had, they expected to gross something like 56,000. This is just in a couple of theatres. They more than doubled that. The earnings so far have been absolutely incredible. And this clip here, I think, gives a real essence of the passion and how raw this film is.
Baseball?
You're not listening to me. I'm trying to explain it to you the best way I know how. It's not easy for me to admit that I've been standing in the same place for 18 years.
Well, I've been standing with you. I've been right here with you, Troy. I got a life, too. I gave 18 years of my life to stand in the same spot as you. Don't you think I ever wanted other things? Don't you think I had dreams and hopes? What about my life? What about me?
Oh, I tell you what, you watch it, but and you come out of there going, oh, wow. But you think about it the next day.
It's one of those ones I think it would be my pick for this weekend, but take some friends and make sure you have a nice catch up afterwards as opposed to having an open mouth sob on your own.
Well, have you got something a little lighter for me?
I do.
Okay, good.
Well, lighter in that it's entertaining. I've been watching Lemony Snicket's series of unfortunate events on Netflix. To be honest, when I was watching it, I thought it dragged on just a little bit and there's no great resolve because it is a series of unfortunate events.
Right.
But before I knew it, I'd watched the whole season. I just binge-watched and I kind of went, oh, okay, I enjoyed that. I'd say it's very Burton-esque in that kind of dark way, but Neil Patrick Harris is very much the star of this. Have a wee look at him here.
He's horrible. Awful.
You haven't the faintest idea.
He is great. Yeah, he's really good.
He's brilliant.
As light as I was hoping for.
No. My kids are watching though. All my children are watching.
But
we're
it's
really
got
liking
that
it.
Great. The villain has so many beautiful comedic moments where you can actually laugh at him because he's actually a bit pathetic.
Yeah.
So I enjoyed that.
And we had Rhys Darby in last week. Is he in that?
He is late. In the last couple of episodes, you will see Rhys Darby as well. And I didn't know before I watched it that he was in there. And then I'm going, oh, look, it's Rhys! So you have that moment as well.
Proud Kiwi moment. Yeah,
absolutely. Fans of the franchise will be fans of this series on Netflix. So that'd be one to download for those wet days. Hopefully we don't see too many of them. soon, though. In terms of events this weekend, off to Waimoku for the Northwest Wine, Beer and Food Festival. Incredible music at this one. So Dave Dobbin speaks for himself, Trinity Roots as well, but also Nomad, and they are just fantastic. Here's a wee taste of them. Love will call at the end of the day. Your heart will ride it out. Love will fall when your face slips away. Your heart can't take it. So that'll be something to eat along to. I love wine, beer and food.
Yes.
And music.
And music.
Funny that. And my Christmas read this year was Jimmy Barnes, Working Class Boy. It is a brilliant book, taking you into just a life that I never imagined. He was going through extreme poverty. He had a really rough upbringing in Scotland and Australia. So the book talks about that, and now he's essentially taking that on tour. But I thought we could have a wee taste of the stuff that he's working on music-wise now, because it's not the cold chisel anymore. He's going back to some of the classics. Have a wee look. So he's in Wellington and Hawke's Bay this weekend, and then carrying on around the rest of the country. So if you've got some spare time, check that out, because you'll be, you know, you will not be disappointed seeing Jimmy Barnes talking about his life.
Yeah, and also the second part of that book is coming out this year, which is where he picks up when he's in Cold Chisel onwards. So that's going to be good too.
And it leaves you, the first book leaves you wanting. So I'm pleased to
hear. Yeah, oh, great things about that book too.
Yeah, it's very cool. I'll lend it to you. I've got it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Braydon. No worries. It is always a pleasure having you in the studio with us. I will be fine.